after watching the movie.
This movie makes me want to cuss.
Scott, cuss, totally cuss, 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 and go! My overall feeling was like, wow, these actors are like an army working so hard to make this a good movie. Yeah. I mean, they really were. Nicole Kidman was very good. Daniel Craig didn't very much, but Daniel Craig is always good. The little girl really was. She added so many complex moments and reactions that you don't usually see from kid actors. Usually it's like, oh, I'm scared because it's a bad guy. This was like, I'm scared, but I hate you and I need to escape. Like, you saw a lot more in her face.
I thought it was terrible.
Yeah. Beyond words, terrible. And they had great ideas.
The bear fight was cool.
Yeah.
The bear fight and Sam Elliott.
Not only is it all exposition, it's the same exposition every time. Every time. She opens the compass and a character will come out of nowhere and go, that's an alethiometer. And you take these three little hands and put them here. And then this one goes back and forth like this and tells you the truth.
What makes it worse, though, is they're not actually talking in any pattern that gets you from point A to point B.
No, they talk about the same things in every scene. Every scene they talk about the same things happen with
no apparent explanation. But what they did is they literally took chunks from here and chunks from here and did this.
Okay? The editors, it's got to be the same
thing. So they took the points that happened here, put them after points that happened here, and cut out the middle.
They did a lot of things, like some of the stuff that Pullman did that was pretty good, like with the master of the school in the book.
Yeah.
He's really conflicted because it's him that tries to kill Lord Asriel.
Yeah.
And he feels bad about it, but he feels like he has to do it. It's this whole huge moral conviction.
In order to prevent the rest of the stuff that he knows is coming.
He knows it's coming.
Happening.
And I was like, what an interesting theme.
But see, that he does it with good motives. He's trying to prevent the children from being hurt. He doesn't want that.
Exactly. I said, but my point is in the movie, they just wipe that out, and the priest comes in. He's like,
since when do polar bears drink whiskey?
Oh, I'm okay.
No, that's actually in the book.
My personal pet peeve is when people tack on visual effects and it makes no sense with the whole going into the thing.
Over and over again.
Well, it's basically saying, no, you didn't get it. You know, just getting you in the nose. Because seriously, the whole mystery of it is, this thing is speaking to you and it's really mysterious, you don't know what's going on, so that when the hands move, it's like a Ouija board. It's supposed to be like, oh crap, what the heck is going on?
They really ruined that.
Yes,
the actual visuals of the environment were really good.
Yeah, they
were. This is a $180 million movie.
They were pretty good. And I was really impressed with the large amount of CG animals that all looked really good.
Oh yeah.
I mean, they were high quality CG.
The demons actually looked incredible.
Yeah, they
Pantamalian,
did.
The main demon, was gorgeous.
Yeah.
So good.
Okay.
I liked the idea of having an animal that represented each person. So as soon as you introduce a character, you know something about them simply by
like their conscience.
This visual cue.
Yeah.
Which is a really cool gimmick. It was just completely wasted.
Yeah. Yep. Literally, it ends with the little girl going, what will we do next? Well, and she looks around at the people around her that are there for no real reason. They just all got on the boat. And she's like, and we'll take this character and this character. And she literally counts off every character and then practically looks at the camera and says, and we'll come back for the sequel next holiday season for
$14.99. So
I didn't read the book.
I only read 1/3 of the book.
I haven't. I haven't read the book.
I read the book, all three, and I loaned it to these two fine folks.
Screw you, Dan.
Shit.
This movie clubs baby seals.
I love when James pops.